Hey everyone, it's me Suchita and welcome back to the channel. I hope you all are doing absolutely fine. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about the questions and the sample answers for a preschool teacher interview. So if you are new to the channel, do consider subscribing and press the bell icon so that you will not miss any new upcoming video. Without any delay, let's into this. The first question is, tell me about yourself and why you want to become a preschool teacher. For this question, you need to include all the qualities of a preschool teacher. First point, you need to show them how much you love your teaching job. This is the job by choice, not by the compulsion that you don't have any other job and you are just trying to be a preschool teacher. You really need to show them how passionate you are about your teaching work. Second point, you need to show them you are caring plus sensitive, because these are small children. They really get hurt with small things, and you really need to have particular about the sensitivity of their emotions. So the sample answer will be, as for the job description, I strongly believe that I do have the necessary organizational and planning qualities to excel in this role. I do have a patience and communication quality and some motivational techniques to help the students in the important and crucial years of their life. Now is the term of the second part of the answer, that I really want to be a preschool teacher because I just love the satisfaction which I'm getting from this job. When you will teach these small children and they'll come and sometimes they just hug you, they say they really miss you when they were on holiday, and at the end of the day you feel like, you know, you're shaping the future of this young generation, and this satisfaction really motivates me to come to the job every day and really feeling worth doing this work. Second question is, how you define success as a preschool teacher in your role? I define success in my role in three ways. First one is how the students will react to my teaching style and the skills. If they will react positively, so that is the first big successful step for me. Second one is their consistent progress report in all the skills. Third one is, if I'm able to make some positive behavioral changes in the students, so that is the best thing I want to achieve in my job role. And finally, if I'll get a positive feedback from a parent that they do observe some educational and behavioral or some manner related changes in their child, so that is a real success, I feel. Because as a parent, they are the best judge to understand what path their child is going, and they are the really keen observer who really can observe what their child is feeling and doing these days. Question number three, how you handle the behavioral issues in your classroom? So you can start with, first of all, I do believe in considering the positive behavior and neglecting the negative one. Second one is, I do believe in maintaining a behavior chart which will really work as a positive reinforcement for my children who are troublemakers. They still get the motivation from the colorful stars of the behavioral chart. And I also observe the child sometimes just do the destructive behavior because they don't have enough activities to do. So if I feel some kind of destructive nature is coming from the child, so I try to involve in more activities as much I can. I give him responsibilities like to bring the register, to distribute the activity stuff to the children. And in that way, I try to control and calm him down and try to motivate him towards the responsibilities and to make him or behave as a good child. And finally, if all these things still will not work, I will continuously record the behavior patterns in the child. I just believe in involving the parents in that scenario. I just held a parent-teacher meeting, and then I just mentioned all the positive behavior of the child, and in between that I'll just mention these are the things the child need to improve, and show the parent all those incidents which I'm recording during the consideration of the pattern of the behavior. And then along with the parent, I try to find out and, you know, plan a strategy which really work for the child, because for me these are 20 children, for the parent is only just one child which like, you know, they have to observe and they have to find out the faults and the reason of this behavior. Plus I had observed once that by cutting down the sugar in the breakfast and by motivating the child to take good enough sleep of 8 to 10 hours plus some meditations really worked well in that case. So I just like, you know, believe in involving parent in a very positive manner and believe in working hand to hand with them to improve the child in all the skills. Next question is, what are the skills and qualities to be a good preschool teacher? I believe in working on 7 specific skills in my nature. The first one is the patience. Patience is the key for the preschool teacher. These are the just, you know, small packets of like small cute children full of energy. So to maintain and to like, you know, involve ourselves with them, we really need to have patience. Second one is supportive. I need to be like, you know, go to the maximum strength of myself to support the child development. Third one is the adaptive nature. Yes, because all children are unique and special, we nearly need to continuous work on teaching strategies and the skills which work well for these children. Maybe some strategies will work well for one student and some will work well for the other child. So we need to adapt ourselves according to the demand of these children. Next one is great communication. If you are able to communicate with them, if you are able to make a bond with them, then only you can make them learn something, because these are innocent children and they don't know anything about the value of education. So the only way to make them learn is a good communication and a good relationship with them. Next one is good organization, because with small children we need to include many activities in our classroom, so we do need to organize. We need many things. If you are not a good organizer, you are not able to complete all the tasks in that particular time frame. Next one is planning. Planning is the key for preschool teaching. If you are a good planner, you are able to finish all the tasks, all the learning and skill related tasks in this particular time frame. Last but not the least is the creativity. To like, you know, make them learn is a art, is a creativity. We need to be creative, we need to attract with them color, shapes, then only you are able to make them learn.